So today I'm going to show you what we did. Well, not I did, but what the hairdressers did for Sarah's prom, okay? Now we went and purchased this Lalabelle's Salon Professional Premium Synthetic Clip-In Hairpiece, okay? So synthetic means it's not real. And it comes in this pretty pink box, which we have been storing it in, and the wig has a hairnet around it, keep it intact. Okay, so we'll take this hairnet off. And even though it says a hairpiece, it's more like a wig because it's one big giant. So get this off first, hold on. Okay, it's like that, it's like a wig, but it's only to be clipped in half of your hair, so from here, okay? And I'll show you how it works. Now, I do a bit of back combing when I'm attaching these combs. On the video, on the website, they actually put it in like a pony and then put the comb through it and attach it on, but her salon didn't put it in a pony, and she said they didn't back comb, but I'm going to back comb probably quite a bit of Sarah's hair. It's kind of how I was taught. If you put any sort of clip-in hair pieces, you want to back comb it a bit, so that's what I'll be doing. So just giving your hair a little comb through to start with. So Sarah dyed her hair red, which is why she went for a red wig, but they come in blonde, they come in brown, only three shades. And I think that's awesome, the red colour. I think it's a very statement piece, you know. I was thinking she's going to look like Jessica Rabbit. Watch.
Sorry.
Sorry about that. I thought she was going to look like Jessica Rabbit, but actually she had her makeup and her big doll eyes. She looked like Ariel. You were a princess.
Yeah.
Under the sea. So, I'll just take it side on so you can see here. Right, you want half the hair, so you need to take a pattern from the top down to where her ears are. Okay, take that section there and then with your tail comb and split it. All right, that's your first section. You want to hold on to that and do the same to the other side. Chin up. Okay. Make sure your sections are clean. Okay. I'm just going to copy it back so you can see this. Head back. Okay, if you turn around to this side. So Sarah, a few months ago, shaved her head here, which is why this is so short here. So we were wanting to put in clip-in extensions, and when we seen this like one piece that starts from half the head, where she's got all her hair, we thought that was a better idea. So, our hair's really short here, so we're going to sweep, once the hair piece is in, we're going to sweep all the hair to where the hair's short. Alright, so to cover that, to hide that. Alright, so you have split your hair into two parts. This front part and this back part. So I'm just going to take a little section at the top part of the hair. Hold that, you can be my assistant. And do a little spray just at the base of hairspray. Take your comb, and you want to have the hair straight up, okay, and comb it down, and make a little bush next section.
Make every minute worth it, baby. This for Arsha, baby. Watch this.
So that's three sections I did, and I'm going to do the same at the sides parts of her hair. Okay, just there.
I done been around the world, I done kissed a lot of girls, so I'm guessing that it's true. Make me holler and I bet $1 million. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Bang, bang, bang. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Don't nobody kiss it like you. It's 5 in the morning, cushions.
For like synthetic wigs, I work a lot with cheap wigs for the dancing, just for shows. We buy cheap wigs and they feel like hair you would get in a doll. This feels
real.
Like real hair. Feels so good, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. Okay. Take a soft brush. So you've got these combs at the front and you've got a comb underneath. Okay, so head back so I can see what I'm doing. And then I'm going to scoop all this hair inside the wig piece. Tuck it in. Sorry, I ran out of space there. I've been videoing a lot of videos recently, so I've been taking a lot of footage of things, and I'm just put my husband's phone on to try and finish this video. So I've tucked our hair in, and then with the comb pushed the wig up there. And Sarah, you said it feels super secure.
Yep.
Even without any curbies, because in the salon they put curbies around it to secure it. So I don't think you need to do that. I think that comb there and that comb there, maybe if you're going out somewhere like super special, you don't want your weave to fly, then maybe like I pop a couple more in. But personally, you, when it comes to hair ups or anything to do with the hair, the least amount of curbies you need to use, the better it looks. Okay, so that's it, it's attached on. You can flip.
I look so pretty.
Flip it back, okay. Now she's got this kind of balayage sort of colour going on where it's dark at the roots, but her colour at the ends totally matches and blends in nice with the colour of the wig. So, but the top part doesn't, it's very two-toned. So we need all this hair to blend in to this hair here. Now in the salon they just blow dried it into the hair. Okay, blended it in. I'm gonna like back comb it a wee bit so it's got a bit of like stiffness to the hair, so it stays put where I style it. Okay, so I like to do it in, again, three sections. Take it from sort of like where your middle of your eyeball is. Okay, there. That's, and then middle of your eyeball, okay. And I start with the middle section, give this a wee comb through, okay. Most people start back and move forward when they're back combing. I'm the only one I think that does this, but it's just how I prefer to do it. I start from the front and then put the hair forward. Okay. Again, hairspray at the base, taking small sections of hair. It's a little bit time consuming, but it's totally worth it at the end. Okay, that's all the sections back home, throw it back. And this just gives the hair a bit of stiffness and a bit of lift and root when I push this back into it. So we're going to put your hair going this way. But where's the tail comb?
Got it.
So I want this part to go here and the rest of it to go straight back. And this part to sweep here. To make it more realistic, the wig, I like to take a bit of hair so you can see the hairline and pull it back and then just stick a clip on it. And if you wanted to do something sort of like a fancy clip or a flower, really pretty, I think it's a nice pretty hairdo, but showing that hairline makes it appear that it's your real hair. So just take a little small section, smooth it out, give it a little twist, take your curb in, and I need to use my mouse, sorry.
It stays in place.
I don't want any bumps. Push the carpet down into the hair. That way you don't see it as much. Okay. And it helps to push the hair back and blend in to the hairpiece. I'm just going to brush out this wig a little bit if you turn around to the side. On. Like, it is super soft. Alright. Okay, stand up and give them a twirl. Okay, this is the hairpiece. You want to give them a twirl slowly.
Rolling while she making staking necks. Yeah. At 5 in the morning, we can only be about to do one thing.
And then you can just like put it to the front. I like it down right to the side. Yeah, it looks pretty like that. Big hair. Yeah. And it doesn't take ages to do, you know. You want to have fancy big curls that you don't need to sit in a chair for hours getting done. Literally, like, that was £30 for that hairpiece. And you just clip it in, blend the rest of your hair into it, and voila, you're ready to go.
Yep.
So, thanks for watching.
Bye.
Bye.